So I don't typically make like resolutions. I like to think of all of this as evolutions in the making. And so it's about going. Would you stop it? Jeez, Louise. Cats like to intervene at times. But I guess I'm going against, the habitual the habitual killer sleigh that gets in my own way, because cranky is how I'm feeling at this moment in time, because tired am I, but we get on our grinds. Reminders have I been given for myself for today to enlighten my ways, to not get frustrated with any delays or all the things that I have to do, because, again, I too am in a state of constant practice of initializing in my world the conscious effort of making sure my vibrations are in alignment with the things that I desire and live to inspire. And so, these checklists that we make, the frustration that comes in when we tend not to, for me, highlight or cross out or get things done, because, sometimes the grueling process, it's not any fun, but we must instill within ourselves and put into practice the things that we desire to bring into fruition. And so me hitting record at this moment in time is me going against that habitual lie of a life that once would have fed me before. I'm so tired. All the things that I do, all the things that I take care of on a day-to-day basis, we all have responsibilities. That is a part of our races. And so I took a step back to acknowledge the fact of everything that I do. Honoring the temple, this shrine, cranky is this feeling, sure, because I need to get to my sleeping. All these days I've been up, passionate, the fire burning inside, the excitement that lives inside of this hive, pushing me past my own limits, these restrictions, these things. So, I share this experience with you because I am not the only one that got to do what we got to do. And so, this motivational tool is also for you as well as it is for me, because hitting record was not easy when I wanted to shower, clean up, and get on my way and hit on my bed, be in sleep to be up again. To do the same things? No. But I'm pushing past my own restrictions, limits. So this is good. Crankiness is something that we're gonna feel from time to time, but we shouldn't take that out on anyone else or spread that venom, because it's not gonna help. But if you find the exhaustion seeping inside your being, you must give yourself rest. You are in this world, at least a human being. Rest, I have learned to understand in a different way for our bodies tell us many things. We just ignore sometimes and look away. But, you know, the energy of today for me is rest that I do need, but I have to honor and recognize the accomplishments that I set out to intend to do for today that I got done, highlighting away. And although there are two other things on my list, reality, you know, takes a hit and it's still being done. There's nothing that's not on our goal or to-do list that has a set time. Sure, we have to meet some of, you know, timelines and deadlines and stuff like that, but there are certain things that we do for ourselves that, you know, we should give ourselves the credit that we deserve, because it is with love that we are creating this. So I just wanted, in all my crankiness, to share this, because there was something that I did want to discuss, but I'm going to save that for when I'm a little bit energetically, like, you know, up, because I am truly exhausted at this time. And I still wanted to give this, you know, a go, and maybe sharing some little rhymes. We should honor our bodies, because everything, I know I always hashtag mind, body, heart, and soul, mind, body, heart, and soul, mind, body, heart, and soul. But truth be told, it is mind, body, heart, and soul in this lifetime, in this earthly realm, that we must honor and take care of in every single way. You know, there isn't one without the other. There is, I mean, they can exist, but the imbalance that might exist if you don't keep it in check. So mind, body, heart, and soul must flow and infuse in agreement with one another. And so although I am physically exhausted, that's part of my body, my mind too. And sometimes, you know, silencing it because there's so many things to do is a hard thing to do, you know, and that is also something else that we should learn to put into practice, of silencing all the chaos and the madness, because we can create a stillness within our beings. Breathing helps a lot with some of these things. There are so many tools that we can use that we don't need anything for. We are the tool. We just have to put in the practice. I'm getting a little stuttery because, like I said, exhaustion is within me, and rest is something that I am going to receive once I send this video on its way. But what can I say? I also posted the card reveals on my Instagram at Enchantress. Excuse me. At Enchantress. I will share them on here as well. I will attempt to put that together before I do say nighty night. But I just want to get this alignment within me feeling right. And this feels right, even though I'm tired. This is passion being expired. Expire to expire is to. I'm trying to find the right freaking word, and I'm so tired right now. It's to expire is to let out, right? To let out. You're expiring something out. Now, we also know when something's expired, it means its time is up as well. So sometimes when I use that word in a sentence, I don't like the way it feels, and so I try to find something else that resonates with that expression. Because we are not expired, but there is these energy fields that we expire from within. So I just got to keep listening and giving it all a go. So now you know, crankiness is something that happens to us all. But how you choose to treat those around you in all your cranky ways, you must step into your higher levels of consciousness and being, and just check yourself before you wreck yourself. Know what I mean? Anyways, this is my cue to go. So now you know. The energy of this workplace today is like chaotic and in a frenzy, and I find that I am just humming and staying within my bubble and still spreading all the love and good cheer that I can possibly spread, because I'm unaffected by the energies that are around me, because I am controller and receiver, and I also am responsible for what I choose to vibrate in. And so with that being said, I hope you all are having a fabulous day, managing your energy in the best possible way that is in alignment with you. Open our eyes. There are so many things that we can highlight that happens synchronistically in our world.
These filters, they make me more in love with myself. It's just like so adorable.
What if he was talking about himself? I found a girl. I know he says he found a girl, but that's just like part of the song. Because we're all convinced and sold on romance. But what if the love that we need is the one that we need to find within ourselves? Because until we do, we won't know what it really is or what it is that we should be receiving from love. So many people say love is this bad thing, this heartbreaking thing. But how can love be heartbreak? People are heartbreak.
Okay, so wake me up before I go-go. But no, seriously, in regards to the reveal for the cards 1, 2, and 3 that I posted earlier this week on Monday shall be revealed very shortly, probably this evening. So if you haven't made your selection, you still have every opportunity to make a selection, whether it's 1, 2, or 3. Maybe it's all 3, who knows, but it's the divine purpose, akashic advice spread. So make sure that you tune in. You can find it on my Instagram at Enchantress, as well as my blog, Enchanting Babble at blogspot.com. And I probably will share it on my YouTube, Enchantress the Babbler on YouTube.